Well, in other news now, a Keene woman is facing charges tonight after she reportedly hit a man out riding his bicycle early this morning and left him in the road. That man later died from his injuries. Jennifer Gannon has the latest from Keene.
Police were called to the scene just before 2 a.m. on Saturday, and the victim had already passed away by the time they arrived.
It appeared that there was no effort made to stop before or after the accident.
It was this stretch of Route 101 in Keene where police say 48-year-old Keon Iannou was hit by a car while riding a bicycle and left in the road early Saturday morning. It's not clear how long Iannou was in the road before the accident was reported to police. The Keene man died before first responders arrived.
We received a report of a bicyclist down in the road on Route 101 near Graves Road. We responded out there and found the victim deceased in the road.
A collision analysis team was called out to investigate. Evidence at the scene suggested the suspect vehicle was a white Saturn. Not long after, police were able to locate the woman they believe was behind the wheel of the car that hit Iannou, 41-year-old Tracy Burrows of Keene.
An investigation subsequently led to Ms. Burrows, and she was charged with two felony counts related to this.
Burrows has been charged with one felony count of leaving the scene of a fatal accident and one felony count of negligent homicide. Police say although an arrest has been made, the case is still under investigation. They're asking anyone with information about the accident to contact them. Authorities are also urging people to take caution and wear reflective clothing while out walking or riding a bike at night, especially on well-traveled roadways.
Route 101 is one of the major arteries on the outskirts of Keene, and it's a well-traveled road, and people tend to can go speedy, they can go fast, and it's got portions that are not well lit.
Burrows is being held on $25,000 cash bail. She will be arraigned on Monday. In Keene, Jennifer Gannon, WMUR News 9.